Kino, obviously, we're here in Port-au-Prince, Haiti, preparing for tomorrow's friendly international. You know, you're coming off a goal-scoring performance in the last game, and obviously your confidence seems to be growing game by game. You maintain a spot in the team over the last few weeks or so. Tell us a bit of how you feel looking ahead to tomorrow's game.
Our team played our first two games, and the vibes in the team are very good vibes. You know, everybody looking forward to put the best, you know, to make the coach had to be studying, you know, who to select on that day. You know, everybody want to play. They say that everybody can't play, but I think the vibes are real good with the players, you know, and believe me, for me, it's a big step because they come into an end in my career. You know, so I just think they make an impact till the end, till 2010. That's that. But yes, I don't know, keep your head up and, you know, come out and do what the coach asks us to do, and, you know, we'll get the job done.
All right, you've been in and out of the national team over the years, won, you know, some problems with injury, etc. It's been a lot of hard work to get yourself back into the team. Tell us about that.
Injury-wise, it's been real hard. And I just pray to the Lord that, you know, to carry me through safely for the next campaign, which is 2010. You know, and it's just keep my fingers crossed and, you know, work hard.
What are some of the strengths you think the team has been developing over the past few months or so since they've been involved in the setup? We've had some decent results. You know, the loss to the Bermuda was, you know, it was disappointing. The England game as well was not what we expected. But you know, the team has continued to believe in itself, and the players have, you know, come strong together. Tell us a bit about that.
The strength of the team basically is that the players being together for a very long time, you know, and just that. For me, that the outside players now, when they come now, it's going to be a little wavy because the outside players come with something to add to the team, and we working on something what the coach wanted us to do and stuff. And it's just that we just had, you know, everybody had to be on the same page. Basically, that's just it.
All right. In the last game, you seemed to have a good understanding with Chris Burchell, the crosses that he was sending into the box. He's not going to be here for tomorrow's game. Obviously, you expect to get similar type of service while you get into that box from another player on the team?
Yeah. I talked to Kerry Batis concerning the free kicks, you know, to be ripping them last close as that's Chris, and he told me once he's on the park, he will deliver. And Chris now, I told him, just keep putting it last once and I'll just get back across, and which he did. Not once, not twice, about maybe six or seven times. And, you know, we get goals up from it. Two goals up came from it.
Yeah.
So I expect him, Kerry, to step up now and, you know, take that position.
Looking ahead to the matches coming up, the Cuba game is important for us to at least get a result. I mean, 3 points is going to be wonderful. How you look forward to that game and the two matches coming up, the Guatemala and USA Red Mountains?
It could be real tough. Really tough. Just had a whole awareness up and, you know, stay together and I said, do what the coach wants us to do. Not just on that day, but during the preparation leading up to the game. I think everything will be